create this Excel chart with me in just 2 minutes. We're going to use conditional formatting and color skills. If your data looks like this, you can easily convert this down in decimals to be in thousands. All you need to do is divide it by 10 to the power of 3, and then we're going to select it all, copy, and we're going to paste special values right on top. Now we need to go up to formatting, and we're going to change this to just general, and then we've got our numbers centered. Next, let's select all of our data and turn the background gray, and then we're going to add some borders. Let's do white, and let's do a thicker line so that it really shows up in between and separates each cell. Next, let's select the bottom half of our data and move it over to the right. You can leave it if you want, but if you needed it to be a shorter chart, this is how you could do it. And then we're going to copy and paste our headers so that they're the same on each side. And we're going to move these a bit so that they're sized properly. Adjust these as you see fit. We're just going to keep moving these. That's looking much better. Now what we want to do is select all of the cells. I'm pressing Control when I select both columns and go up to conditional formatting and color scales in a new rule. Our minimum is going to be an icy blue and the maximum is going to be a bright red. Hit OK and there you go. Now let's select these rows and go to insert so we've got a spot for our title, and let's title this something appropriate. This happens to be average household income in the US by city. And then we want to put a note here, maybe the year of the data and that it's in thousands. And then if you go to the bottom, you can put where your source is. Ours happens to come from Statista. And let's select these again by pressing Control and clicking both and turning that font to a gray. We could add italics. And then we want to do the same type of formatting to the title, making that larger, bold, so it really stands out. Now you can divide this a bit by using the border function again. So on the bottom, let's go to borders, and then we're going to select that double line and add the border. And now you've got your chart.